Let's animate and rig a car. Welcome, I'm Dragon, and today I will be showing you how to animate and rig a car, and I will be using one of my own cars, but let's get into it. Start by getting a car or using one that you've already made, and then you can make sure the wheels are separated. The reason for them being separated is so that you can rotate these wheels and they can rotate freely. Then add an empty. I use a cube just because that seems standard. Now move the empty up, then parent the wheels to this empty. The reason for that is so that you can move the car with the wheels connected. Driver time. So drivers, you get this to work by clicking on the wheel, then going into the properties tab. You have to go to the rotation so then you can see the wheels spin. So as you can see, when I spin on the Z axis, it spins the right direction of the car. So this is when you right click and go down to add driver. From adding the driver, you go onto this cool driver tab, and where it says object, select empty, the empty that you just barely added. Then under type, go to the location that your car is facing. If it's facing the X axis, then choose that. If it's Y location, like my case, then choose that. And then where it says expression, you go into this and type times one or times whatever. You get to play around with that. The faster, the higher the number, the faster the wheels will spin. By the way, you can use any math operator, not just the times operator, when using drivers. Now to show you that it works, I'll move the car, and as you can see, the wheel is spinning, but it is spinning the wrong way. So to fix this, I go back into Edit Driver and make the positive number into a negative number. Now that we have a working driver, let's copy and paste that and paste it into those other wheels on the Z-axis so that it's still spinning the same direction. Now that we have all that copied and pasted, we now have a simple rig. But let's make this more complicated and make the wheels turn left and right. To do this, you will need another empty. Personally, for this one, I use an arrow. The reason for the arrow is so that I could see what direction it's facing, but you can choose any of them if you want to. For this empty, I just move it front into the front of the car, and then move it up a little bit, and then parent it to the other empty that I already had. Now for drivers again. So for this driver, it will actually be going onto the wheel again, but going onto the x-axis. Yours could be the y-axis if that's the direction you're wanting it to turn, but you add a driver, and under the driver, you again go to object and select the second empty this time. And then for type, you go to the Z rotation. It should be the Z rotation no matter what direction your car is facing, because this one's just facing on up and down. And for the expression, I actually leave it alone and don't touch it at all at first. But as you see, the wheels are turning the wrong direction. So to fix this, I go back into Edit Driver, and for the expression, instead of going plus just zero, I do divide by -1. But this is the same as times -1. I just decide to do divide. Now you could see when I rotate the second empty along the Z-axis, you could see that the wheel actually spins. The one difference is, and problem is it can rotate too much. And the other wheel isn't rotating yet, so let's just copy and paste it and to the other wheel, and then let's fix the issue that it can over-rotate. I just want to mention real quick that the reason that I'm not using all four wheels is because in a real life car, I only see the front two wheels moving like that, so I decided that's what I should do. But now, to fix the over rotation, we can go into Object Constraints and choose Limit Rotation. When you choose Limit Rotation, this will pretty much just limit just like it says. To limit the correct rotation, check the Z and then limit it negative 30 degrees on the top one and 30 degrees on the bottom. You can change these values if you think it's limiting too much or too little. Now we have a working car rig. So as you could see, I can't limit it or I can't move it too far that it over rotates and looks really weird, but it does work now and I think it looks great. But let's do a quick animation now. So to get the animation going, add a curve and then rotate this curve so it's facing the right direction as your car. It may already be, but now go into edit mode and create a curve that you think you want the car to follow. So once you have this curve, you can then go again to the Object Constraints tab and select your first empty and select Follow Path. Under Follow Path, set the target to your curve, then make sure your car is rotated right. Otherwise, go to select the curve again, but this time without the target, and go to Path Animation. Set this to however long you want this to be for frames, and then make sure that the evaluate is set to zero at first, and then go to whatever frame that you set it to and select that same amount. Then when you animate that, you'll see that your car follows the path. But as you can see, it doesn't look quite right. So let's fix that. To fix this, you could see that I am rotating the first empty that we had along the z-axis and then just keyframing it until we get to the end of the path. Once we get to the end of the path, you could see that it does look a little bit better. The thing is the wheels aren't rotating right. So to fix this, I go to my second empty that we added and then just rotate this until I think it looks right. And there you go. Now you have a simple car animation and rig. If you want to make it look better, then you can just play around with decorations on the side. Other than that, thanks for watching. I hope you found it helpful, and bye!